Big trouble wrong.
That's okay, Dave. Look. Okay, basta, te lo sto dicendo.
Yeah, that's just a problem. What's on it feel?
Hello!
Hey!
How I look? Good? Che la bella di papà! Allora, oh, la mamma mia che si bella! Oh. Ma... Oh, that's my princess!
Papà, yes. You look very nice.
Oh, thank you. Hey? Oh. See? Avrà shoes sono like a guapi.
Papà, you look good, papà.
Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you and that your satisfaction may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you."
You know, Teresa, when we were in the sacristy there, and it was 5 minutes to go, and you were not here yet, so I think that Michael, he was a little bit shaky. There is also a door there. It's called escaping door. No, he didn't go through that. He just look out and see if you were coming. But a wonderful, that is love, you know, and a wonderful to be here all together today. So my dear friends, you have come together in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church ministers and this community.
I, Michael, take you, Teresa, to be my wife. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life.
I, Teresa, take you, Michael, to be my husband. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life.
So you have declared your consent before the church. So may the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessings. What God has joined, no human being must divide. So Michael and Teresa, I declare you husband and wife. Congratulations.
I always love when my brother comes home to visit. Doesn't matter how old we are, the second he walks through the front door, we instantly start acting like kids again. If I could teleport back in time, I wouldn't change a thing. What I would do, though, is go back and lock in every one of those carefree, youthful moments and bring them with me. I've mentioned so many already, but there truly are 1,000 more memories and stories that I can bring up. So what I'm gonna do today is make sure that I lock in every second of this moment. So when you leave back to Toronto and the party's over, I'll always be able to hold on to this exact feeling. Michael, thank you for being an amazing brother. I'm proud of the man you are and the man you're gonna be. I'm so happy that you found Teresa. She's so much better than you, and it's not even close.
Teresa, where to start? We've been friends since our teenage years, And the moment we met, it felt like we were sisters, talking about everything from our crazy Italian parents, no offense, we're all Italian. Oops. Mike, you're obviously a very lucky guy, as your brother said. I'm just kidding, Mike, we love you. And anyone who knows Teresa knows that it didn't come easy. But Mike had to chase Teresa around Sport Truck, where they worked together for a few years, before he finally got her contact information. And it wasn't even her phone number. She started with her email address. It was at something at hotmail.com, right? Yeah.
Mom, I remember when I was younger, you walked Anthony and I to Vail for soccer games. Every Thursday night. You took care of us when Dad went to those weekend hair shows or hunting and fishing long weekends. It couldn't have been easy dealing with the two of us fighting, stabbing each other with pencils, throwing rackets at each other. But you always seem to handle it well.
Ma, Papa, Yellow. Hey, okay. I promised myself I need to keep this short because I love you so much with all my heart that when I think of everything you've done for me, for us, my heart and my eyes literally burst, which results to excessive tears and ugly crying. Tonight, we're celebrating Mike and I, but the reality is we're honoring our parents and how they've molded us and guided us to become the individuals that stand before you today.
Today, I'm the luckiest man in the world because I have the privilege of marrying the most incredible woman I have ever known. I remember the first time I saw you. It was as if I got hit by the thunderbolt, like Michael in The Godfather. I knew you were the one I wanted to spend the rest of my life with. You captivate me with your intelligence, beauty, and endless compassion. Your infectious smile lights up my world, and your unwavering support has given me strength in every aspect of my life. We've come so far since we first met. We graduated from our programs, we moved to Toronto, and we bought a house together. Today, as I look into your eyes, I'm overwhelmed with a sense of excitement for the future of what we will build together. I promise to be the best husband I could be. I promise to cherish you, to love you unconditionally, to support you in every step of our journey together. I'm grateful for the memories we have created so far, and I'm even more excited about the memories we will create in the future. I love you.
Holy moly, we did it. 13 years in the making, and here we are today. You are officially my husband. Now, you're stuck with me. You got no way out. You know the saying, when you know, you know? Well, I'll tell you exactly when I knew. I was growing old with Mike. It was our first anniversary. He nervously passed over a sheet of paper labeled Teresa. It was cardboard paper. It was baby blue, just to be exact. He awaits anxiously for my reaction as I begin to read. You are my one and only, the one I love. When I look at you, I think you've come from above. I love it when you laugh. I always can't wait to see you smile, even though I sometimes have to wait for it. It's always worth the while. This one's the best one. This is what won me over. The way you look at me fills me up with desire. I get real hot inside, like I'm sitting beside your fire. I'm stopping here because I hope you understand why I'm marrying this man today. He's a poet, if you guys didn't notice. He's a poet. Even though I'm pretty sure
Those were Backstreet Boys lyrics. I'm pretty sure, but I don't know. I don't know. I need to confirm, but I'm pretty sure. Mike, I would have waited another 20 years if I knew I would have ended up with you. I love you, and I look forward to the rest of our lives together. Thank you. So I've been going around the table, and I've been saying that the dance floor is white, but I expect it to be pure black tonight from dancing too hard. So please, thank you guys so much for everything. We love you. Thank you.
And let's have a good time tonight.
Cruise on the back roads and byways, windows down, and I'm bored.